boys and girls. Again, I hope you're enjoying this beautiful weather, so make sure you're getting out and enjoying that. Today we get to read chapters 10 and 11. And the title of chapter 10 is Freedom of the Press. Does anyone know what that means, freedom of the press? Basically, freedom of the press is when news reporters, they have the freedom to ask people questions. Y'all have seen this a lot with the coronavirus. Reporters asking the governor questions, reporters asking President Trump questions and things like that. That is called freedom of the press. These are news reporters that go up and they have the freedom to ask leaders and elected officials, for example, questions about things that are going on. And they also have the freedom to print their responses and how they respond to things and things like that. So that's what freedom of the press means. So I want you to think about, why would this chapter be called freedom of the press? Do you think this Frindle business is going to get pretty big? Why would the press get involved? So just be thinking about that as I read today. Freedom of the press. Judy Morgan was a reporter for the Westfield Gazette, the local newspaper. Westfield was a quiet little town. There was the occasional burglary, the teenagers got rowdy once in a while, and there was some shouting at the town council or the planning board now and then. But mostly things were pretty calm and orderly in Westfield. And every Thursday, the Westfield Gazette proved it. Ted Bell sold advertisements for the paper, and he had a daughter in fourth grade at Lincoln Elementary. He told Judy that a bunch of fifth graders were making trouble and were not obeying teachers anymore, that there was something about a secret code word they were all using. And half the students had been kept after school one day last week, including his own little girl. The only other story Judy was working on was about 18 new trees that were going to be planted along East Main Street. The trees could wait. This thing at the elementary school sounded like a real story. So, Judy Morgan showed up at Lincoln Elementary School at 3 o'clock the day after Mrs. Chatham had been to visit Nick's parents. The sign on the door said, "All visitors must report to the office," and she did. On the bulletin board outside the office, Judy saw Mrs. Granger's notice about the punishment for using the word Frindle. She stepped back 2 paces, aimed her camera at the notice, and snapped a photo. She read the notice once more and then stepped into the office. Mrs. Freed, the school secretary, looked up and smiled. "May I help you?" "Yes, I'm sure you can. My name is Judy Morgan and I work for the Westfield Gazette. I'd like to know about that poster outside the office, the one about this word, Frindle. Who should I talk to?" Mrs. Freed stopped smiling. She was sick and tired of anything to do with that word. For the past week, her phone had been ringing off the hook. If it wasn't a parent complaining about a child who had to stay after school, it was someone from the school board trying to get in touch with Mrs. Chatham and Mrs. Granger. Mrs. Free pursed her lips and narrowed her eyes. She said, "You'll have to speak with the principal. Let me see if Mrs. Chatham is free." She was. There isn't a principal alive who won't find the time to talk to someone from the local newspaper. The reporter was invited into Mrs. Chatham's office. Judy noticed right away that the principal was not comfortable talking about this stuff. When asked about the poster outside the office door, Mrs. Chatham laughed and said, "Oh, that? It's nothing really. Some kids have been playing a prank and it was time to put a stop to it." The principal's laugh sounded phony to Judy Morgan. "And did that notice put an end to the prank? I heard that a lot of children were kept after school last week. Would you tell me a little bit about that? Parents would like to know what's going on." Mrs. Chatham looked like, well, like a kid who had been sent to the principal's office. She squirmed a little in her chair and tried to smile. She said, "Well, we do still have a little problem, but it's under control. Mrs. Granger may have overreacted a bit. I don't think the children have really been trying to be disrespectful. They are just having some fun, and it's more like a difference of opinion." And then Mrs. Chatham went on to tell the reporter what she knew about the word Frindle, and how it had become popular among the students. Judy Morgan took careful notes. And when the principal had finished, Judy said, "Would you mind if I ask Mrs. Granger a few questions?" Mrs. Chatham said, "No, not at all." But Judy could tell that the principal wished she would just go away. What could she say, though? Mrs. Chatham couldn't very well keep the reporter away from Mrs. Granger, because after all, America is a free country with a free press. If Judy really wanted to, she could talk to Mrs. Granger sooner or later. It was sooner. In 3 minutes, Judy Morgan was standing at the doorway of room 12, looking in at Mrs. Granger. There were about 15 children sitting at desks scattered around the room, busy writing out their 100 sentences. She knocked and the teacher and students looked up from their work. "I'm Judy Morgan from the Westfield Gazette. Mrs. Granger, may I have a word with you?" Mrs. Granger stood and came out into the hallway and closed the door. Judy could see past her and saw that every kid in the room was straining to listen. Judy noticed Mrs. Granger's eyes right away. Gray, maybe flecked with a little gold and very sharp, but not hard or mean, just bright and strong. The reporter didn't waste words. "So I hear that you plan to stop the students from using their new word. How goes the battle?" Mrs. Granger did not smile, and her eyes got even brighter. "First of all, it's not a battle. I am merely helping my students to see that this foolishness should stop. Such a waste of time and thought. There is no reason to invent a new and useless word. They should each learn to use the words we already have. But of course, all of this is just a silly fad. And when you add an E to fad, you get fade. And I predict that this fad will fade." Judy looked up from her notepad and asked, "Any idea how it all got started?" Mrs. Granger's eyes seemed to almost catch on fire to that question, and she said, "Yes, I have a very good idea how it all got started. It was one young man's idea, a fifth grade student named Nicholas Allen. And now you will have to excuse me, Miss Morgan, for I have papers I must grade." And with a brief, firm handshake, Mrs. Granger ended the interview. The reporter didn't leave right away. She walked back through the hallway and sat on a bench outside the office so she could look over her notes to make sure they made sense. It took her about 5 minutes. Then Judy stood up, put her notebook into her large black purse, waved goodbye to a frowning Mrs. Freed, and headed out the door. As she walked to the parking lot, 5 or 6 kids who had just finished writing their sentences for Mrs. Granger came out another door. Judy walked beside them, listening to them laugh and joke. Then she asked them, "Why do you kids keep saying Frindle? Don't you hate staying after school?" A boy who was almost falling over from the weight of his backpack looked up at her and smiled. "It's not so bad. There's always a bunch of my friends there. I've written that sentence 600 times now." And then the kids said Mrs. Granger didn't even look at their punishment papers anymore. They were sure, because where you were supposed to write, "I am writing this punishment with a pen," everyone was writing the word Frindle every 4th or 5th sentence. And Mrs. Granger hadn't said anything. One girl bragged that she had written the word Frindle 45 times on her sheets today. She grinned and said, "That's a new record." "And this boy named Nick," Judy asked, "has he had to stay after school too?" The kids giggled, and a tall boy with reddish brown hair and glasses said, "Mrs. Granger has kept Nick after school so much that everyone thinks she wants to adopt him." The reporter smiled and said, "Do you think I could find Nick and talk to him this afternoon?" The boy looked at Judy for a second and then said, "I don't think Nick would want to talk to you right now. He might say something stupid and get himself in trouble." Then he grinned at his friends and the kids laughed and poked and punched each other and headed off down the block. Judy drove back to her office and started writing. Here's a picture of a writing assignment they had to do. Whoops, sorry. The wind got it. The next morning, a brown envelope arrived at the Gazette offices, addressed to Judy Morgan, and below her name was written Frindle Story. When Judy opened it, there was a class picture. The fifth grade at Lincoln Elementary School, Mrs. Granger and the 6 other teachers were standing at the ends of the rows, and the kids were dressed neatly, hair all combed. But there was something odd about the picture. The reporter looked closely and saw that each kid was holding up a pen, and each little mouth was puckered in the same way. She was puzzled for a second, but then she said softly, "Of course, they're all saying Frindle." Written on the back of the picture in neat cursive was, third row, fifth from left. Judy looked at the picture, and there she saw the same grinning red-haired boy with glasses that she had talked to in the school parking lot yesterday. She chuckled and said, "Well, well, well, pleased to meet you, Mr. Nicholas Allen." Remember when the children were leaving school and she was asking questions and the boy said he had written the sentence 600 times and that he probably doesn't need to say anything because it would get him in trouble? Who was that? That was Nick. And so he's the one that sent Judy Morgan the fifth grade picture. So he's doing anything it takes to win too, isn't he? So remember, yesterday we talked about this whole word war being a chess match. And if you've ever played chess, it goes back and forth until you have a winner. And so Nick is all about winning and Mrs. Granger is all about winning. So what do you think? Is there going to be any give here? All right, so now I'm going to read chapter 11. So the title of it is Extra, Extra, Read All About It. That's a saying for something that's in the what? A newspaper. Okay, remember Judy Morgan is the newspaper reporter that has got this story going on, the Frindle story. So now do you think it's going to get out to the public? Probably so. On Thursday morning, the Westfield Gazette was delivered to all 12,297 homes and post office boxes in Westfield. The story about Lincoln Elementary School was the first item on the front page, and the headline, "Local fifth grader says, move over, Mr. Webster." It was quite an article. Not that Judy Morgan didn't tell the truth. Every statement in the article was completely true. It was the particular way she told the truth that got things hopping around town. For example, take this sentence about Mrs. Granger. Mrs. Granger, champion of the forces of order and authority, is battling hundreds of young Frindle fighters. Neither side is giving in. Or this bit about Nick. Everyone agrees that Nick Allen masterminded this plot that cleverly raises issues about free speech and academic rules. He is the boy who invented the new word. Or this last sentence in the article. One thing is sure. The kids at Lincoln Elementary School love their Frindles, and no one seems to be backing off in this war of the words. And of course, the Westfield Gazette published the class picture too, and Mrs. Granger and Nick were identified for all the world to see. What is the meaning of this? That's what Nick's mother said, putting the article in front of Nick's nose when he got home from school. Did you talk to this reporter? She seems to know an awful lot about you and your new word, young man. What is the meaning of this? That's what the school superintendent said to Mrs. Chatham, slapping a copy of the article onto her desk. Why did you have to talk to that reporter? Don't we have enough trouble getting the taxpayers to pay for the schools without articles like this banging around town? What is the meaning of this? That's what Mrs. Chatham said to Mrs. Granger, shaking the newspaper in front of her face. I know you had to talk to that woman, but did you have to say all these things? It'll be a wonder if we don't all get fired. It was quite a Thursday for everyone, and no one could figure out how Judy Morgan had gotten that fifth grade class picture.